Hi guys, today I want to tell you about this lovely red cattleya. Her name is Wendy's Valentine June. I bought her in 2013 from the Helsinki Orchid Show, and the name of the orchid nursery was I Ching Orchids from Taiwan. She's a lovely red orchid. It has a very intense red. In the beginning, when the flowers open, it's kind of magenta, but then as the days goes by, and then it becomes redder, and the lip has a very rich, strong, dark yellow color that is almost orange in the morning. It's very beautiful. And the flowers, they are about 10 centimeters wide, or that will be 4 inches. It has no fragrance at all, but it doesn't really need, does it? It's just so beautiful, and look at the shape of the lip. It's just so beautiful. This is a cross from Cattleya Jean and Cattleya Paprika. Cattleya Jean is a primary cross of Cattleya or Sophronitis cochinia and Milleri. And Cattleya Paprika has a very interesting ancestry. It has a lot of, a little of everything. It has Cattleya Darwiniana, Purpurata, China Barina, Mossiae, Schroederi, and Harpophylla. So you can see where it gets the color from and also the shape. It has a very beautiful lip. And this is considered a mini Cattleya. But it's not as mini as the smaller ones. I would say this is about 20 centimeters high. It's a great windowsill hybrid. It's very easy to grow, doesn't demand too much light. Cattleya light, but it does well in many different kinds of settings. And it usually flowers twice a year. I know in the USA it usually flowers twice a year. Here in Finland, sometimes only once. It depends on how much light we can provide during the winter. You see, this is not a tall plant at all, and it's very beautiful. It flowers for me about the Christmas time, and also now in June, as the name says, when it's Valentine in June. I suppose the June comes from the time this hybrid usually flowers there. It was registered in 79 in the USA, and it has an award of merit by the Honolulu Orchid Society and American Orchid Society. I have one flowering pseudobulb now and two pseudobulbs growing there. I use sometimes rubber bands to keep them from growing to the sides, so it grows upwards. I really love this hybrid, so nice. It's so nice to have it blooming now during the summer too. It's a very beautiful lip with a very beautiful markings. You can see the Darwiniana influence on it. I warmly recommend this to anyone who wants a beautiful Cattleya that's not too demanding. Well, this is it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and give a thumbs up if you like it, and subscribe for more. I'll try to post at least once a week. We'll see. Have a very nice day. Bye bye.